انما جزاء الذين ناؤ, دس از دی رول فار دی مسلمز ناؤ. دیٹ واز اے اسٹوری وچ واز ریلیٹڈ آف ابیل اینڈ کین, ہابیل اینڈ قابیل. ناؤ ود دس بیک گراؤنڈ وٹ از دی کمانڈمنٹ ناؤ؟ انما جزاء الذين يحاربون الله ورسوله, ویئرلی دی ریکمپنس of those who go to war against Allah and His Messenger. And you know, after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Islamic State takes the place of Allah and His Rasul. Whosoever is rebellious against Islamic State, in the times of Rasul, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, going war against the Messenger of Allah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحَارِبُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. But now, after his death, it's the Islamic State. If a real Islamic State is present, established, whosoever stands as a rebel against it, who wages war against it, إِنَّمَا جَزَاءُ الَّذِينَ يُحَارِبُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَيَسْعَوْنَ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَسَادًا, and they want to make mischief in the land, the recompense is only أَنْ يُقَتَّلُوا, they should be murdered, killed. And تَقْتِيل means they should be butchered. تَقْتِيل, not only qatl, yuqtalu nahi, yuqtalu, they should be butchered, aw yusallabu, or they should be crucified, aw tuqatta aydihim wa arjuluhum min khilafin, or their hands or feet should be cut from opposite sides, aw yunfa min al-ard, or they should be exiled from the land, turned out from that land. Zalika lahum khizyun fid dunya, and this is going to be for them a dishonor in this world and degradation in this world. وَلَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ, and in the hereafter there will be for them a very big punishment. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا مِنْ قَبْلِ أَن تَقْدِرُوا عَلَيْهِمْ, except those who repent and mend their ways before you overpower them. Now just look to it. There's an Islamic State. Some people have stood up in rebellion, challenging the state, waging war against the state. Now, before the state is able to overpower them, if they repent, if they make tawbah, and if they amend their ways, then they will not be killed. But if the state has overpowered them, and then they say, we make tawbah and we apologize, no. The time of tawbah, gone. That is the thing given. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَعْبُوا مِنْ قَبْلِ أَن تَقْدِرُوا عَلَيْهِ, except those who repent and mend their ways before you overpower them. فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, so you should know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also forgiving. Then forgive them, because they have on their own repented and mended their ways. Allah is merciful. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَةَ وَجَاهِدُوا فِي سَبِيلِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Oh, you who believe, have taqwa of Allah. وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَةِ, and seek the ways and means of becoming nearer and nearer to Him. If you are really mu'min, if you love Allah, you must gradually, this is called suluk, to go. Sair ilallah, you are approaching Allah, not with your feet, with your heart, with your heart and mind, you are becoming nearer and nearer and nearer to Allah. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullah wabtaghu ilayhi wasila, means of becoming nearer and nearer to Allah. And what are these means? This vow now, it is the vow of tafseer, vow of explanation. وَجَاهِدُوا فِي سَبِيلِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, and strive hard in His way. This striving hard in the way of Allah is the wasila. The harder you strive in the path of Allah, the nearer you come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَةَ وَجَاهِدُوا فِي سَبِيلِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, so that you may be successful and prosperous. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْ أَنَّ لَهُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا, verily those who disbelieve and reject the faith, لَوْ أَنَّ لَهُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا, had with them be had they got with them all the wealth of the whole of the world, وَمِثْلَهُ مَعَهُ, and more with it, twofold of the whole of the wealth of the earth, لَيَفْتَدُوا بِهِ, to ransom themselves from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ, from the punishment on the day of judgment, مَا تُقُبِّلَ مِنْهُمْ, it will not be accepted from them. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَلِيمٌ, and for them is a very big and painful torment. يُرِيدُونَ أَنْ يَخْرُجُوا مِنَ النَّارِ, they will keep on trying to get out of the fire. وَمَا هُمْ بِخَارِجِينَ مِنْهَا, and they will not be able to get out of it. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُقِيمٌ, and for them will be the punishment which is lasting, persisting, permanent. مُقِيم. والسارق والسارقة, now the second thing, as I told you, respect for human life. The other thing is respect for property. You shouldn't steal. You can have a bargain, you can have trading, you earn from each other. You can work for somebody and you can get the wages from him, everything, okay. But to steal, that is wrong. وَالسَّارِقُ وَالسَّارِقَةُ, and a thief, whether he is a male or a female, فَقْتَهُ وَأَدِيَهُمَا, chop off the hands of both. This is the punishment. جَزَامْ بِمَا كَسَبَا, it's the recompense for what they have earned. نَكَالَمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ, it's an exemplary punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah wants to eradicate theft from the society. And definitely, these, you know, punishments of Islam, they are exemplary. They are very stern, no doubt. But we accept, yes, they are correct. Without that, you know, this theft and murdering, it cannot be rooted out from the society. What is happening to the West? Despite all the education, all the means of persuasion, all these communication, media, everything is there. Still, most heinous crime, it is prospering here. Why? Because the punishments are not strong. You can have the example of some of the Muslim countries. For example, used to be the case in Saudi Arabia, no theft whatsoever. But now, because they themselves have become loosened, you know, it's a different case now. But a few years earlier, about 10, 15 years earlier, no theft, no trace of any theft. Only during the days of Hajj, because, you know, people came from other countries, especially Yemenis, they committed theft. But no Saudi individual never committed any theft. وَالسَّارِقُ وَالسَّارِقَةُ فَقْطَعُوا أَيْدِيَهُمَا جَزَاءً بِمَا كَسَبَا نَكَالًا مِنَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ فَمَنْ تَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ظُلْمِهِ, whosoever repents and mends his way after committing this sin, وَأَصْلَحَ, he has corrected himself, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَتُوبُ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, so Allah will also turn towards him with compassion, with mercy, with forgiveness, and he is the forgiving one and he is the merciful one. So now, this is not, you know, if you have committed the theft, you have incurred upon you two things, a punishment here and a punishment in the hereafter. Tawbah will save you from the punishment of the hereafter, not of this world. If a thief says, thief says, well, I make Tawbah. Okay, you must make Tawbah so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, he saves you from the punishment of the hereafter. But here, this had of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is hududullah, it must be executed. The punishment will be given here.